way, oh. Mm-hmm. Ooh, way, oh. Mm-hmm. Ooh, way, oh. Mm-hmm. Ooh, way, oh.
Hey guys, my name is Laurel Delaney and I am a current senior here at Glen Burnie High School. Every year, Black History Month marks a time for us all to be able to self-reflect, celebrate, and recommit to all of the achievements of equality and justice for all. Today, we get to celebrate GB style.
Lift every voice and sing till earth and heaven rings, rings with the harmony of liberty. Let our full of the faith that the dark past has taught us. Sing a song full of the hope that the present has brought us. Facing the
Glen Burnie High School. My name is Drake Smith. I'm a senior at Meade High School, and you're a student member of the Anne Arundel County Board of Education. I'm so happy to be here today. I was invited by Ms. Brown and the SGA to talk to you about Black History Month. But luckily, I'm not here alone. I'm joined here today by a very special guest, Carolyn Williams, and I'll let her introduce herself right now.
Hello, students of Glen Burnie High School. My name is Carolyn Williams, and I had the privilege and honor of serving as a student board member during the 2016-17 school year. And I'm also a proud alumna of Glen Burnie High School and was a part of SGA while being here. This school holds such a special place in my heart. Believe me when I say that Glen Burnie produces excellence. Each of you is destined for amazing things. Continue to work hard while you are here. Never doubt yourself and know that there is a community of people rooting for you. While here, I put in a ton of work and landed myself at the illustrious and now presidential Howard University. Historically, Black colleges and universities have always produced excellence. This is nothing new. But now the world has no choice but to take us seriously. We have landed ourselves in the White House. The 49th Vice President of the United States, Kamala Harris, is the first woman and the first African American to hold the post. She had previously served in the United States Senate and as Attorney General in California. Vice President Kamala Harris walked the same halls as me, ate in the same cafeteria as me, and lived in the same dorm buildings. She chose to study at Howard because it is an environment that allows people of color to learn without judgment and reach their full potential. Howard is home. I say all of that to say that you are living among historic times for people of color. And this Black History Month, be proud of who you are. Be proud of how far you've come and realize that this excellence does not stop here. We are the change makers America and beyond needs. Believe in yourself, bet on yourself, and continue to soar. I'm sure my fellow Bison, Vice President Harris, would agree. Black is beautiful and we are capable of achieving anything. Happy Black History Month. I'm now going to turn it back over to your wonderful leader, your current SMOB, Drake.
Wow, Carolyn, that was great. That's that Howard education for you, I guess. I would just say everything you had to say pretty much summarizes Black History Month. It's all about learning where we came from, because you don't know where you're going unless you know your history, where you've come from, right? You're not the first one in this position. You're not the first one to have these struggles. And I think you touching on Vice President Harris, I think that was perfect, because a lot of people think, you know what? She didn't just wake up one day to become the vice president. She had to start somewhere. And a lot of people, I think a lot of students don't really know where to start at, right? Where am I going to start that journey to become great? Well, I think that's what really holds a lot of students up. What is greatness? And I think Dr. King, in his Drum Major Instinct speech, he really summarized greatness. He made it something that anyone can attain. Dr. King said, everybody can be great because everyone can serve. And I think that's all what it's all about, right? At your time at Glen Burnie High School, at your time at college, just make sure you serve your fellow person, your community. And I think that everyone is destined for greatness. So this Black History Month, don't just try to learn the history, make the history. Who can you serve this month? And once again, we want to thank you for having us here. And, I wish you all the best of luck for the rest of this school year.
Talk, tick, talk, tick. Talk. A lot of time has gone by, let us not lie, but let's spend this time talking about some famous Black history lives. All are amazing, I know for sure, but I can only put so many in a few words or more. Let's see what impacts have made in our world. Look at the Little Rock Nine. They helped with the desegregation of schools, and now we can roam about and socialize as freely as we choose. And did you know that Rosa Parks wasn't the first to refuse to give up her seat? It was actually a teenager, 15, named Claudette Colvin. But Rosa Parks was a better symbol for the Montgomery bus boycott. Either way, it caused an upstir for the civil rights movement to continue its plot. Booker T. Washington, born into slavery, became an educator, then taught lessons to the many, leading Tuskegee University to be the top of the country. Barack Obama was our first Black president back in 2009 through 2017. Which really says it all in the title, an example of what Dr. King was dreaming. I wonder who we have next to inspire future dates. But no need to wait, I'm looking right at it. As we grow up, older, and wiser, we hold the narratives, opinions, and voice to make the right choice. And education is that key, In result, we become free.
Hello, my name is Carl Snowden. I'm an Annapolitan living here in the city of Annapolis. I've been a native Annapolitan. And I wanted to share with the viewers a couple things that have happened to me over my life experience. I've had the great pleasure of meeting Oprah Winfrey, Alex Haley, James Baldwin. These are men and women whose names you would be familiar with. But there are other people I've learned about as a result of studying Black history. You know who, obviously, George Washington was. He was the founder of our country. He's called the father of our country. You know, of course, who James Madison was. James Madison was one of the people who contributed to the Declaration of Independence and the Bill of Rights. But do you know who Madison Washington was? Do you know who Madison Washington was? Madison Washington was one of those African-American heroes that most Americans have never heard of. Most people think, for example, that our new vice president, Harris, is the first person to occupy the office of vice president who had what's called a blended family. A blended family is a family that's racially mixed. As you know, Vice President Harris' family has a white husband and white stepchildren. Well, what most people don't realize is that Thomas Jefferson, who was the second vice president of the United States and who wrote the famous Declaration of Independence, he too had a blended family. But that's a family that nobody talks about. Sally Hemings was his slave. She had children by Thomas Jefferson. Most Americans are oblivious to the fact that the first family or the second family has indeed had persons of color prior to Vice President Harris being elected the first vice president and first woman in the country. These and other topics I look forward to talking with you about, sharing with you various experiences that I have. And I want to end on this particular note. It's one that I'm very fond of. I met James Baldwin when I was a very young person. And I had an opportunity to hear James Baldwin speak in Baltimore, Maryland. He was an eloquent speaker. And at the end, I asked him a simple question, something I wanted to know. What should I do, I said to him as I was thinking about my career and what I would like to do when I graduate from high school. He looked at me and said, read, read, read. Never stop reading, never stop writing. He said, because in reading and writing, you will find your place in life. And I've never forgotten that. And I look forward to talking with the students and sharing with them those experiences. Thank you for this opportunity.
Hello, my name is Elizabeth Morris, and I'm a judge on the Circuit Court for Anne Arundel County. The Circuit Court is the highest trial court in Maryland. It's where we have jury trials, we hear criminal matters, civil matters, and family law matters. In 2018, Governor Hogan appointed me to the Circuit Court for Anne Arundel County, and when he did, I made history by becoming the first Black woman judge appointed to the Circuit Court for Anne Arundel County. The Maryland Constitution requires judges who are appointed by the governor to run for election. And for me, my election was in 2020, and thankfully, it was successful. I won the election. And when I did, I made history again by becoming the first Black woman elected to the Circuit Court for Anne Arundel County. I want to be a lawyer for as long as I can remember, and that dream would have been seemingly impossible because of my background. I grew up with a working class family, hardworking working class family that didn't have a lot of money. Our social group, a lot of people didn't go to college, and certainly no one had ever gone to law school. But I was able to achieve my dream with hard work. And just as important, surrounding myself with people who really believed in me, who provided guidance and mentorship every step of the way. So my message to young people, particularly young girls, who have a huge dream, there's a couple things I want to say to you. One, you can do it. Believe in yourself, work hard. But the really message I want to get across today is make sure that you surround yourself with people who believe in you. Because if you have even just one person in your circle who is negative, who doesn't believe in you, who's not encouraging, that can have a detrimental effect on your dreams and your success. So choose who you surround yourself with very, very carefully. So finally, I just wanted to end by thanking you for including me in your Black History Month program. It's truly an honor to have been included, and I hope that you have a wonderful day.
Hey guys, happy Black History Month, and in honor of Black History Month, I'm here to tell you guys about HBCUs. So what is an HBCU? Well, an HBCU is a historically Black university that was founded before 1964, and it was built on the premise of giving African Americans an education. As we know, African Americans were not given that opportunity, were not given the chance to even dream of going to any colleges. And we know, especially in the South, they were completely banned. So even if they were able to, they couldn't do it just based on law. And indeed, HBCUs stood up in a time where they needed to, where they needed to help the community out. And even to this day, they're continuing to do such great work. And they've faced, especially back then, how hard it must have been to open up an historically Black university and in face of so much injustice. It's impressive. I'm blessed to say that I was accepted to Howard, and that is just one of many, many, many different HBCUs around the country. And they've done, and they continue to do so much for the community. We have a lot of HBCU alumni in Glen Burnie High School, but let's hear from Mr. Caldwell what he thinks.
Hello, I'm Mr. Caldwell, and many of you know me as a school counselor at Glen Burnie High School, but some of you may not know that I'm also an alumni of Glen Burnie High School, class of 96. And I am also an alumni of an HBCU, Morgan State University. Go Bears. So when I think of my experience of attending an HBCU, one of the first things that comes to mind are my professors. And I can honestly say that this was consistent across the board, that my professors would always instill a sense of pride and a sense of responsibility in me as a person of color to always operate in excellence. And that was a theme that was common at Morgan State University. It was a theme because, when we look at the history of African American people through slavery and through the civil rights movement, we are people who have had to overcome and to persevere through a lot of hardships. And so as students in college, we are able to be in the position that we're in because of the sacrifices of those people. And that really instilled a sense of purpose in me, you know, as a student, because it made me feel that I was doing something more than just getting an education for myself. I was contributing to the upliftment of people of color. And so as I move, it was something else that was also talked to us about, to move forward, but to also reach back to help other people to move forward as well. And so those type of lessons and hearing these things come from our professors and really feeling that they had a vested interest in my success is something that I really valued about, you know, attending Morgan State University. Some of the other things that I really valued were hearing the perspectives of different types of professors from all across the world. I had professors from Africa and Ghana, different places, different countries in Africa, and Trinidad and Jamaica. And just hearing the stories that they had to tell me about, you know, life in their country. So not only getting the perspective of, you know, the history as it pertains to African Americans, but the history as it pertains to people of color all across the world. You know, I very much valued, you know, that, you know, and as a student, again, that attended an HBCU, you're obligated to take a class called the African Diaspora. And so there were elements of my history that I didn't know anything about until I was able to take classes like that, where I learned about, you know, how the original man came from Africa and how we were, as people, dispersed all throughout the world in different places, the Dominican Republic and Cuba and different, you know, different ethnicities that, you know, I never, you know, really thought of that had roots in Africa. And so, you know, with that being said, I think that the education that I was able to receive from Morgan State University was something that I value greatly, something that really helped me to understand who I was, you know, as a person of color, to have a deeper understanding of it. And it's something that really resonated with me moving forward, you know, in everything that I do. I'm proud to say that I attended an HBCU and were able to receive those lessons from my professors and have that sense of pride in who I am. And so for any student who, you know, has any plans of attending an HBCU, I think it would be a wonderful experience for you to do so. And, you know, I welcome any questions that students may have or, you know, want to talk about as it relates to my experience in more detail. But I can honestly say that it's something that I cherish wholeheartedly. So thank you for allowing me to share. Go Morgan.
Black excellence is nothing to be ashamed of. Black excellence can and sometimes will begin with failure. Black excellence is a part of Black culture in our Black communities. Black excellence is not being afraid to fail. Black excellence is not being afraid to conquer. Black excellence is not being afraid to step out of your comfort zone. Black excellence is our past Black leaders fighting for our rights. I know my Black excellence. Do you know yours?
Thank you so much for celebrating with us today as we continue to strive towards unity. And remember, change will not happen if we wait for someone else or some other time. The time is now. We are the people we've been looking for, and we are the change that we seek.